So, Kalkalosh, we're going to start. This is today's daf is daf Kaf Dalid 24A1. We are going to start. We're at the two dots, which is four lines down, Ibailehu. And the Gemara is going to ask, or if you want, we'll just start at the beginning of the page, but we've already did it. We said Tarika Tedder of Chasta, there was a proof that according to the Surah of Chasta, where it says, Kol Elu Shamru Malikim Bayim Shabbat, anything which they don't light on Shabbat also. It says, Malikim Shabbat, Malikim Yom Tov, you could light it on Yom Tov, except for Shemin Serefa. If you Shem Tov, Kod Shemin Yom Tov, you're not allowed to do Kod Shemin Yom Tov. Yesterday, we already mentioned the question that was quote, that instead of a proof, that's also a question against him. We mentioned there the answer. Fine, it says the two dots, okay? Ibai Lehu. You know what, let me just put this on.
So it says here like this, Ibai Lehu. So we're asking the following question. What is the halakha of mentioning Chanukah in Birkat HaMazon? Which means, right, to do with the concept of Al HaNisim. Kevan de Midrabanan hu lo matkirinan, since it's Midrabanan, so therefore they didn't obligate us to mention anything, right? It says, right, that means unlike Yom Tov or things like that, which is going to be in the Alevi of Obiz, it's Toraita. Well, Dilmar, maybe Mishum Pirsumenisa Matkirinani, maybe because Pirsumenisa, we are going to mention the different holidays and the different things that we're having. Okay? That's what we're asking. So it says over here, or Dima Mishum Pirsumenisa Matkirinan. So Amar Rava, Rava Kandani says, Amar Rav, right? Zechor Amar Rav Huna says, Rava in the name of Zechor in the name of Huna, Eno Maskir. You do not mention it. Vim Bale Askir, but if you do come to mention it, Maskid Beoda, you're going to mention in the thank you, which is no delecha, which that's what we do. We say Al Nisim over there. Ravuna Bar Yehuda Ikla Leve Rava. Ravuna Bar Yehuda went to visit Rava. Okay, Vesaval Leat Kure, and he thought to mention it. So when? Bebone Yerushalayim, Bone Yerushalayim, which is later on. So Amar Lehu Rav Sheshat, Rav Sheshat comes and he tells him, right? Kitfila? He says it should be in Tfila. Just like Tfila is Behoda'a. So to be Amazon, which means like this, in Tfilah, where do we say it? We don't say it in Bnei Yerushalayim. We say it in Tfilah in the last three blessings, which is thanking HaKadosh Baruch Hu. After Modim, we come and we thank HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and we say, Al HaNisim. So too, in Birkat Amazon, we're going to thank HaKadosh Baruch Hu in the Nod Lecha, which even though it's in a different order, because in Birkat Amazon, the Nod Lecha is before Bnei Yerushalayim. But that's the way that's supposed to be. So now the Gemara is going to ask, okay, fine. So Ibai Lehu, now it's interesting because it's written at the beginning that Eno Maskir, which means that you don't have to mention it, but if you do want to mention it, this is where you mention it. So it's much more that Be'emet, not even Lechatchila, even though we know that Lechatchila, we do mention it, just B'diavad, if you didn't, nothing happens. Ibai Lehu, another question. Ma'u Laskir Rosh Chodesh B'Mikad HaMazon? Do you have to actually mention Rosh Chodesh B'Mikad HaMazon, which is Ya'alev Yavo? Meaning the Chagim, for sure you have to mention. But what about Rosh Chodesh? He says, "Intim tzilomark bechanukah derabbanan lo tzadich." If you're going to tell me on just like Chanukah, which is going to be derabbanan, you don't need, and Rosh Chodesh doraita tzadich, and Rosh Chodesh is doraita, therefore you would need it. Well, Dilmar, maybe I'm going to say no. Maybe because Rosh Chodesh is not prohibited in doing melacha, it's not like a Shabbat or Yom Tov. Lo maskirin. Maybe we're not going to mention it whatsoever. So Rav Amar, Rav says maskir, you're going to mention it. And Rav Chanina Amar, Eno Maskir. Rav Chanina says you don't need to mention it. A proof to Rav. Amar Rav Zireka. Nekot Rav Bidcha. Grab Rav, what Rav said in your hands, because you do have to mention it. Tekai Rav Oshia Kavatebas. Rav Oshia holds like him. Tetane Rav Oshia was Rav Oshia Tarna Braita. Yamim Shesh Baim Korban Musaf. Any day that has a Korban Musaf. Kegon Rosh Chodesh Yecholosh Al-Mu'ed. For example, in Rosh Chodesh or Chol HaMu'ed. He says, Arvi V'Shachritu Mincha Mipalel Shwona Esreh. Arvit Shachrit Mincha, you're going to pray Shmona Esreh, Ve'omer Me'ena Me'ora, and you're going to mention the Ya'alev Yavo inside of it. Im Lo Amar, if you didn't say it, Machzirinotu, you have to say it again. Now remember, he said Yamin Sheish Bem Korban Musaf, and he brought down Rosh Chodesh and Chol HaMoed. So he says you do have to mention it. Ve'im Lo Amar, and if you didn't mention it, Machzirinotu, you go back. Ve'em Ba'en El Kiddush Alakos, they don't have Kiddush Alakos, which means you don't need to say Kiddush. Yes, by Naskarab, Birkat HaMazon, but you do have to mention them in Birkat HaMazon. So this is a proof. The fact that it says you have to mention them in Birkat HaMazon is actually a proof to what we just mentioned beforehand, that you do have to mention it on Birkat HaMazon. Okay? That's what's actually brought down. Fine. Now it says as follows. Yamim she'en bahen korban musaf. Days that you do not have korban musaf. So it says, kigon, for example, sheni v'chamishi u'tanit, taniyot, or ma'amadot. So any days, which is basically like Mondays and Thursdays, or tanit sibur, any type of a communal fast day, or taniyot u'ma'amadot, or different taniyot that they had to make for different occasions, whether it was because it wasn't raining, or whatever the case, the circumstances was. So it says, sheni v'chamishi mayamitayu, what exactly are we talking about to do with Mondays and Thursdays? Right? What exactly are they doing over here? Okay? So it says, Ela, but rather you're right. Sheni v'chamishi v'sheni she'tanit. We're talking about Mondays and Thursdays and Mondays of a ta'anit, which is called ta'anit bahab. Monday and Thursday and Monday. Okay? So it says, also ta'aniyot ma'amadot, also the ta'aniyot of ma'amadot, which is in any of these types of tefillot, arvi v'shachritu mincha, mitpalev shmona esle, you're going to say amida, ve'omer mena me'ora v'shomet tefillah. You're going to say anenu, remember on a ta'anit, you say anenu. So you're going to say anenu in shomet tefillah. If you didn't say anenu, en machzirin oto, you don't have to go back. Okay? Now it says, you don't have to go back. Okay, then it just says in brackets, you don't have kiddush al kol, so obviously you're not going to do kiddush. Ve'en ba'en haskara v'birkat HaMazon. So now here, you do not say the haskara v'birkat HaMazon. So here we're talking about in the nighttime when it's still permitted to eat, because obviously on the ta'anit, you're not going to be eating. So it's talking about the night before, you're not going to mention anything in the birkat HaMazon. Okay? Which means it's true. Anenu or anything like that, you don't mention Birkat HaMazon. You mention it in Amida, but not in Birkat HaMazon. So now says the Gemara, Ibailehu, now we're going to ask the following question. Do you mention Chanukah and Musaf? It says, what's the Safek exactly? Meaning in the Tfilah Musaf. I remember, on Chanukah, you don't say Musaf. You only say Musaf on Rosh Chodesh. And that's when you're going to say Musaf during that day of the Rosh Chodesh. So it says, Kevin de lepe musaf bididde lomat kerinan du, he said that since on its own, Chanukah never obligates musaf, so therefore you don't mention the alanisim in musaf of Chanukah, or dilma, or maybe yom shuchayav arbat filot. It's on the day. Today, which is Rosh Chodesh, there it's going to be Rosh Chodesh Tevet. When it's Rosh Chodesh Tevet, you're going to be obligated in a fourth filot. So in every single tefillah, you're going to be obligated to say alanisim. So Ravuna and Rav Yehuda, Damni Tavayu, Ravuna and Rav Yehuda both say, Eno Maskid, you don't say Ala Nisim in the Tfilat of Musaf. And Rav Nachman and Rav Yochanan, Damni Tavayu, Rav Nachman and Rav Yochanan both say, Maskid, you do have to mention the Ala Nisim in Tfilat of Musaf. Okay, so Amar Rabbi Rav Yosef, says Rabbi to Rav Yosef, Had Ravuna and Rav Yehuda, Dravu. This Ravuna and Rav Yehuda is the same halacha with regarding to Rav, which means, they said that you're not going to say Allah Nisim B'Tfilat Musim. That is the dat of Rav. Ta'amar Rav Gidal Amar Rav, Rosh Chodesh Chal Yom B'Shabbat. According to Rav Gidal Amar Rav, when Rosh Chodesh falls on Shabbat, Hamaftir Ben Avi B'Shabbat, and Tzrich Laskish Rosh Chodesh. If you're saying the Haftarah, you don't have to mention at all the Bracha of Rosh Chodesh. You just say, Baruch Hashem, Mekadosh Shabbat. Why? Shil Malei Shabbat, because if it wasn't for Shabbat, En Navi B'Rosh Chodesh. On Rosh Chodesh, you don't say any Haftarot. So therefore, just like you don't say any Haftarot on Rosh Chodesh, so therefore, now that it's Shabbat and Rosh Chodesh, the Rosh Chodesh is not going to change anything in the Beracha. So therefore, I just finished Mekadesh Shabbat. So therefore, this Rav Huna and Rav Yehuda, that they both say you don't mention Ala Nisim and Musaf, is the same Shita, as if to say, as Rav. So says the Gemara, Midami, can you compare the case of Rav to this case over here? Hatam Navi B'Rosh Chodesh Leka Klal. There, you don't mention at all any Haftarah on Rosh Chodesh. Hacha baba here, ite be'aviv shachrit mincha, you're mentioning al nisim in arvit shachrit mincha. So the question is, do you just add the extra al nisim in Musaf? Meaning, by Rosh Chodesh, there's no haftarah at all. So if there's no haftarah at all, now that I'm going to say haftarah, I'm not going to mention anything of Rosh Chodesh. But over here, to do with al nisim, you are mentioning al nisim. You're saying al nisim in arvit, you're saying al nisim in shachrit, you're saying al nisim in mincha. The only question is, you added also Musaf. So don't compare both cases. So says the Gemara, El lehadam, yeah, but rather it's going to be compared to another case. The Amar Rav Achtavoy, Amar Rav Matna, Amar Rav, says Rav Achtavoy, in the name of Rav Matna, in the name of Rav, Yom Tov Shechal Yo B'Shabbat. What happens when you have Yom Tov that comes out on Shabbat? Hamaftir benavi b'mincha b'shabbat, the one that's reading the haftarah, right after the kriyat Torah of mincha, eno tzarich lazkir shel yom tov. You do not have to mention of yom tov. That means you don't mention yom tov whatsoever. Okay, so therefore you just say Baruch Mekadesh Shabbat Yisrael Zamanim, right? But you don't say that. But rather, what do you say? Mekadesh Shabbat. Shil male Shabbat, as if it wasn't for Shabbat. And Navi b'mincha b'yom tov. You don't say Navi and mincha yom tov. So basically, if it wasn't for the fact of Shabbat, there's nothing there on yom tov. Okay. So now it says over here. Now there in Shachrit of yom tov and Shabbat, you do have the Navi, but in mincha of Shabbat and yom tov, you don't have Navi, so because of the Yom Tov. So because of that, you're not going to mention anything. Okay, so therefore it comes out that it should be the same halacha. Just like over there, we do mention it in Shachrit, but we're not going to mention it in Mincha, because Mincha has nothing to do with Yom Tov, meaning the Haftarah has nothing to do with the Yom Tov. So to here, the Musaf has nothing to do with Chanukah, so I wouldn't mention it. Right? However, though, Kavdala Damubet, we do not paskin like all these brightot. Rather, that which Rav Yoshua ben Levi says, that what? Yom HaKippurim shechal yom b'Shabbat. When you have Yom Kippur that falls out on Shabbat, HaMitpalel Ne'ila tzarich lazkir shel Shabbat. The one that says Ne'ila, all that means is when you're going to pray Ne'ila, you also have to mention Shabbat and Tefillah. Why? Yom HaShintcheyev b'Rabat Tefillah. It's a day. The day is obligating you in four tefillot. So today you're obligated in four tefillot. So therefore today it's on the thing. So therefore, even though on a normal Shabbat there's no ne'ilah, the ne'ilah is only because of the Kippur. But the second that you're already praying ne'ilah, you have to mention of Shabbat. Why? Because it's a day. It's on the concept of the day. Now he says, Kashe hilchata hilchata. Now one psak halacha is arguing another psak halacha. Why? You told me that the halacha is like Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi. That Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi says that on Ne'ilav Shabbat, you have to mention Ne'ilav Shabbat and Kippur, right? Again, it's because of Kippur that you have Ne'ilav. So Ne'ilav Shabbat and Kippur, you have to mention, right, the concept of Shabbat. The Kaimel HaNilchata Kerava, we pass in the Kerava. The Amar Rava says, Yom Tov Shechal Yom B'Shabbat, Yom Tov that falls on Shabbat, Shliach Tzibur Yoreh Lifnei HaTeva Arvit, the Shliach Tzibur that goes down to be Shliach Tzibur on Arvit, Eino Tzarich Lazkir Shiyom Tov, you don't even have to mention of Yom Tov. Meaning the Beracha Achat Me'en Sheva, which is the Chazrat Hashat of the Friday night, you only just say Baruch Atah Hashem Mekadesh Shabbat. You don't say Mekadesh Shabbat V'Yisrael Zemanim. Shil Mare Shabbat, as if it wasn't of Shabbat, En Shliach Tzibur Yored Be'arvi B'Yom Tov. Shliach Tzibur doesn't do a Chazrat Hashat on Yom Tov. So therefore, what's coming out is that here we're mentioning that it comes out a very interesting halacha. It's a stira between one halacha and another halacha. The halacha is like Rabbi Yoshua Ben Levi, that on Kippur and Shabbat, you have to mention in the Ne'ilah Shabbat. Even though Ne'ilah has nothing to do with Shabbat, you still mention it, but it's the day. The day is causing everything. Today, you're obligated an extra tefillah, so you have to say it. However, though, what about on Yom Tov that comes out on Shabbat? When you have Yom Tov that comes out on Shabbat, for example, last year, okay, Pesach is not the best example, but because you don't say Me'en Sheva anyway, but let's pretend you would have. When you have Shabbat and Yom Tov together, so on the Friday night of Shabbat and Yom Tov, you're not going to mention Mekadesh HaShabbat Yisrael V'Zimanim. You're only going to mention, right, Mekadesh Yisrael, Mekadesh HaShabbat. That's it. You don't mention Yisrael V'Zimanim. Why? Because it's nothing to do with one another. So therefore, Kam Chachamim, and they say, but this is a stira from one halacha to another halacha. So says the Gemara, Hachiyashta, can you compare both cases together? Hatam, over there to do with the Beracha Chacham and Sheva, you didn't even have to say it on a regular Shabbat. But only the rabbis instituted it because of Sakana. Why did the rabbis institute it because of Sakana? Because remember, they used to pray in the fields, and if they wouldn't, right, if they wouldn't say the Beracha Acham and Sheva, people would just finish, go home, and then you leave other people in the field by themselves, and it's dangerous. So because of that, the rabbis were the ones that instituted Beracha Acham and Sheva. But to do it here with the Tfilav, Ni'ilav, Kippur, Shechal Yom Shabbat, Yomu Shinitcheva Batfilot, which means that Tfilal Ni'ikar is Ne'ilah, is from the Ikar of the Tfilot Ayom. So therefore, you cannot compare the Tfilal Ni'ilah, which is the Ikar of the Tfilot of the Yom, and Abraham Me'en and Sheva, that you don't even need it at all, really. It's only just the Takanat Chachamim. Okay? Fine. We're now at the two dots. The two dots said, Velo Ve'aliyah, you're not allowed to use the aliyah, which is you're not allowed to use from anything that comes from the tail, any types of the oils, or lo bechelev, or the fats. And then Nachuma Madi Omed, you could use chelev nevushal, you could use cooked chelev, cooked prohibited fats. Chachamim omrim, echad mevushal v'chel shem mevushal, emal kibo, you're not allowed to light with it, whether it's mevushal or not mevushal. So it says the Gemara, Chachamim ha'inutan akama. He says, one second, the Chachamim, that they are the ones that say that you're not allowed to use anything, whether it's mevushal or eno mevushal, that's a Tanakama. Which means right before, right, Nachuma Madi Omer, that they say, Malikim Mevuchel Mevushal, we already had a Tanakama that said, Lo Be'alya Ve'lo Be'chelev. So Lo Be'alya Ve'lo Be'chelev is the Tanakama saying you're not allowed with Chelev. All of a sudden we have Nachuma Madi saying that you could have with Chelev Mevushal. And then we have Chachamim saying, doesn't matter whether it's Mevushal or not Mevushal, Emalikim Bo. So one second. So the Chachamim is Tanakama. Answers the Gemara. The difference between them is that Rav Bruna Amar Rav. Rav Bruna Amar Rav. What does that mean? He says that you're allowed to light, right, with Chelev Mehutach if you put a little bit of Shemen, which is permitted. Which means as long as you add permitted oil, you're allowed to light with Chelev Mehutach, with Chelev, which is Mevusha, prohibited fats, which is actually cooked. Okay? Velo Mesayme, but the Tanaim did not finish Talacha. Right, that he was Mekel like Rav Bruna, right? And therefore that's why it comes out like that. So that's the difference between them. Okay, which means so here it just says, but we don't know which one is more Mekel like Rav Bruna. Is it gonna be the Chachamim or the Tanakama? Okay, that's what it says here afterwards. The one of the Tosfos is gonna start asking. Okay, fine. Okay, it says a Mishnah. Okay, there's a Mishnah Kavtala Damubet. Okay, emalikim shemen serefa b'yom tov. You're not allowed to light the candles of Yom Tov with shemen serefa. Remember, shemen serefa is oil, right? Which is of tumat me'ah, which you have to burn anyway. So you're not allowed to light with shemen serefa b'yom tov. B'yishmel omer b'yishmel says, emalikim b'itran mipinei kavod haShabbat. You're not allowed to light with nerot from itran, which is basically, it says over here, it's a psolet tzlula kashemen shemezachkim mizefet al yedei chum, which means that this is like the refuse of the oil which comes out of the zefet of the tar, right, with heat. Okay, so you're not allowed to light with itran. How do you translate itran in English?
Tar.
Tar. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that's what it is, a refuse of tar. Okay. It's the Nekvod Shabbat. Again?
It's the leftover of the tar.
Exactly, the leftovers of the tar. Yeah, that's what it says here. The refuse, which is a psolet, which is leftover of the tar that you get through heat. So it says v'pnei kavod haShabbat, because if not, you're going to be pogim in the kavod haShabbat, because basically this it has a very, very bad smell. And then what's going to happen is that you're basically going to leave the room and you're going to start, you know, eating in darkness because you can't stand the smell. So because of kavod haShabbat, you're not allowed to light with itran. Chachamim atrim mechol hashemim. Chachamim, they permit you with all the oils on Yom Tov. B'shemen shemushamim, b'shemen egozim, b'shemen senor, b'shemen nadim, b'shemen gomer, b'mitan omnet. So Chachamim come and they permit you to use all the oils, whether we're talking about sunflower seed oils, oils of walnuts, oils of tzinonot. It says over here, tzinonot is shemen ha'netzah mizera tzinon. Ah, it comes from the seeds of the radishes. Okay, b'shemen dagim, with oils of fish. B'shemen pakuot, we're talking about a type of a tzemach, type of a b'itran of neft, whether from the tar or from neft.
Neft is the gas, you know, like
gas, yeah, petroleum. Okay, the b'itrafon, and the b'itrafon says, emalikin and b'shemen zayi bilvad, that you could only light with shemen zayi. So basically, they were going to have a machloket over here, right? Because here it says that tarim argue on the b'itrafon, they permit all the types of the shemanim. They actually are modim that there is a mitzvah mina muvchar in shemen zayit, because obviously it makes so much thing, or it either gets very, it draws the oil very nicely, or if the candle is very, very clear. So that's what they do agree to it. However, though, do they permit all other types or not? Okay, so now one second. We started with Yom Tov, and then we finished with Shabbat. Here it says we're talking about on Shabbat and Yom Tov. We were never talking about Yom Tov by itself. Okay, so the first part of when it says Malikim Shemizavim Yom Tov, it's Yom Tov that comes out on the Shabbat. Okay, fine.
But it said in Madlikim Beshemen Serefa Bayom Tov. So what, the Shabbat is as mutar?
Yes, and the reason why is because you're not allowed to burn kolchim on Yom Tov. That's the only reason why you're not allowed to do it on Yom Tov. So we had a Havamina, if you remember in the previous daf or two dafim ago, we had a Havamina. What about on Shabbat? Maybe I'm going to come and tilt the candles, that way it gets all the oil in order to burn the kolchim quicker, because the truma quicker. Because you're supposed to burn the truma as quickly as possible. But then we came and we answered that no, we don't suspect that.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, fine. Says the Gemara. So again, Gemara Kavdala the Mubet. My Tama, what's the reasoning why we're not allowed to light on Shemen Shul Tumat Tumab Yom Tov? So says the Gemara, if you shed Sofim Kochim Yom Tov, you're not allowed to burn Kochim Psulim on Yom Tov. And the same halacha would apply to Truma Tumea on Yom Tov. Right? Remember, here the Kochim Psulim or Truma Tumea has the same halacha that you have to burn, that you have to burn it. So here it says you don't burn them on Yom Tov. Menanamile, how do we know this? So you're not allowed to burn it on Yom Tov. Amar Chizkia, Chizkia says, "Vehem talit veChizkia." Also, we learned in the Kalim Yechizkia. Amar Kalt says in a pasuk, "Velototinu imenu al boker." You're not allowed to leave anything over from the boker. We're talking about the Korban Pesach. So the Korban Pesach, which is eaten on the 15th of Nisan, which is Lel Yom Tov, you're not allowed to leave anything until the morning. Panotinu imenu al boker, but Shisofu. Now, anything which is left over, you have to burn it in the morning. Shenta mulomar ad boker. What is it coming to teach you the word ad boker until the morning? Right, which means if it was just written "Vanotan imenu beesh tisrofu," right, I would have already known that we're talking about until the morning. So "Mata mulomar," what does it mean to say "ad boker" until the morning? "Va'akatub liten lo boker sheni lisrefato," which means that the Gemara is going, the Torah is giving you an extra boker after the boker rishon, which that's when you have to burn it. Which means you're not burning it on the first boker; you're burning it on the second boker. What is the second boker? Cholamoy. Because remember, obviously we're doing one day on Yom Tov. If you're doing one day on Yom Tov, you're not burning it on the same morning of Pesach, because you're not allowed to burn it on Pesach. You have to wait until Ad Boker, until another morning. What's the other morning? The next morning. The next morning is Chol HaMoed, but you're allowed to burn it. So from there we learn, you're not allowed to burn any type of Kodshim, which became Pasul. Here we're talking about Kodshim that became Pasul, because basically the Korban Pesach after the leftovers becomes Pasul. Okay, and therefore you're not allowed to do it on Yom Tov. So Abaye Amar, Abaye comes and he says, no, I've got a different pasuk to teach you. You're not allowed to burn kochim sulim on Yom Tov. Amar Kar, it says in the pasuk, olat Shabbat b'Shabbato, velo olat chol b'Shabbat, velo olat chol b'Yom Tov, which means you're only allowed to bring a korban olah, which is basically the tamidim or musafim, the korban musaf or the korban tamid, which is brought on Shabbat. Right, that's the only thing which is allowed to be brought on Shabbat. But you're not allowed to bring an olat chol, which is basically any types of the evarim, right, of the korban tamid aver of Shabbat, on Shabbat, or, right, not of the olat chol on Yom Tov. So therefore it comes out, if you cannot burn on the Mizbeach, kodshim kesherim, right, when the sirifa is not coming because of the same day, so kol sheken, you cannot burn kodshim sulim on Yom Tov, if it's not coming because of the obligation of the same day. Which means you could only do that which is obligated on the same day. You cannot do anything else. Okay, that's what the Gemara is saying. So Rava Amar, Rava comes and he says, Amar Ka, there's a third way of learning, a third pasuk. Not because of the first one, which was the Ad Boker, to give you an extra morning for the Korban Pesach to burn it, for the leftovers, or the Olat Shabbat, the Shabbat O, and only on Olat Shabbat, not the Olat Chol, not on Shabbat Yom Tov. There's a third one. He says, Hu Levado Yaselachem. You are only permitted to cook on Yom Tov, of doing Nisu Melacha on Yom Tov, which is of Ochel Nefesh, that is only, for example, Shchita, Rafiyah, Bishul, that's only going to be Mutar when it's Hu, when it's something which is going to be something which you're going to eat itself, right, which you need for food, Velo Machshirin, right, and nothing to do with Machshirei Ochel Nefesh, which means I cannot make a Shipud, a skewer, in order to roast with it, or a knife, in order to slaughter, or a Tunur V'Chinayim, right, an oven or things like that in order to bake or to cook, right? Or levado, right? That's the only thing which is permitted. Velo mila shelo bizmana, not a brit mila which is not bizmana, which means a brit mila which is not bizmana, you're not allowed to do it on Yom Tov or Shabbat. Okay? That ve kal vachomer, because it comes out from a kal vachomer, which means if it wasn't for the fact that it was written, hu levado yase lachem, the word levado was extra, right? So therefore, the word levado is coming to exclude brit mila, which is not bizmana on Yom Tov. So just like a brit mila, which is not bizmana on Yom Tov, right, which is a mitzvah she'en zmana kavua, is doche, right, that's what he's saying, it's not going to Dochei Yom Tov. So to any mitzvot, which is like, for example, Srifat Kochim, right? It's not Zman Kavua. So if it's not Zman Kavua, so it's not going to be Dochei Yom Tov. Which means Mila Bizmana is a Zman Kavua. So Mila in the proper time, Brit Mila in the proper time, since it has a fixed time, so it's going to push off Shabbat and Yom Tov. However, though, the second it was already pushed off, it's not Zman Kavua. You have to do it as soon as possible, but it's not Zman Kavua. The second it's not Zman Kavua, it gets pushed off because of Yom Tov. And where do they learn that? Because of the words, Hu Levado Yaselchem. That's the only thing that you guys can do. Anything which is done for the actual day of Yom Tov. Okay? Another explanation is Ravashi. Ravashi Amar, Shabbaton. Right? It's written Shabbaton. Right? What does it mean? What does it come to teach you the word Shabbaton that is written by Yom Tov? Right? Kafei Amud Aleph. It comes to teach you Alaseh that it's going to become a mitzvah Aseh of Shvita Melacha on Yom Tov, which means there's a positive commandment of not working on Yom Tov as well. V'havel Yom Tov Aseh ve'lo ta'aseh. So it comes out that Yom Tov is actually a positive commandment and a negative commandment. It's a positive commandment because it says Shabbaton, which means you have to rest. And it's a negative commandment because it says Kol Melacha Tov Lo Ta'aseh, you're not allowed to do any type of work. So therefore, En Aseh Tochet Lo Ta'aseh Va'aseh, which means when you have a mitzvah to say a positive commandment, for example, of burning kochim that became pasul, or a positive commandment of burning truma that becomes pasul, we do not say that a positive commandment, which is basically the burning of kochim or truma, is going to push away a positive and a negative commandment. Because here you have a positive and a negative of Yom Tov. The positive of Shabbaton and the negative, lo ta'aseh kol melacha. So because of that, it comes out that's going to be another reason, right? So how many reasons do we have? We have first reason was Chizkiyah, which is basically the reason of Lo Tuminu HaBoker. You're giving an extra boker to Korban Pesach. You're not going to burn it on the morning of Pesach. It's only on Chol HaMoed. Second reason of Abaye, because he said Lot Shabbat B'Shabbato, only the Olat Shabbat you could do on Shabbat, but not on Olat of Chol you could do on Shabbat and Yom Tov. Third reason, which was Rava, that he says Hu Levado Yaseh Lachem, the Hu and Levado, Hu is Lo Machshidin, which means only things which are the actual ochel nefesh, things for food, you could do on Yom Tov, but not the machshidin of ochel nefesh, you could do on Yom Tov. Levado comes to teach you that only milah bizmana, but milah shelo bizmana cannot do it, and therefore it's a kavah chomer. If milah shelo bizmana, you cannot do it, so to the srifat kochim, which is not bizmana, you cannot do it also on Yom Tov. And then you have also, Ravashi comes and he says, the last one, that it's a positive and negative commandment in Yom Tov. Because it says Shabbaton, it's positive. Lo ta'aseh kol melacha, right, is a negative. So there, kol melacha lo ta'aseh, sorry. You're not allowed, it's a negative. And therefore, the positive commandment of burning trumat, shenitmeah, or kochim, which became pasul, does not push off the positive and negative commandment of the Yom Tov. Okay, so we just finished this is Dafka.